Well, and children and vines, I would say, change your time scale. When I, before kids and before vines, I think about this year and my career kind of thing, right? But when you have children or when you plant a vine that's going to be there for 20, 30, 40, 50 years, the end of their story is long after the end of my story, right? And so we want to give our kids a good start and launch them, but they're a huge part of our legacy, and they're going to be out there doing whatever it is they're going to be doing, AI management of vineyards or whatever it is, for decades after we're gone. So it's interesting to think on a longer time scale, and it's a change.
Yeah, that's a great analogy. The raising children and raising grapevines.
In finance, they're thinking about the next quarter, and it's like, okay, how can we maximize shareholder value in 3 months, as opposed to, how can we set this vineyard up for a century of productive farming? How can we set our family up to be successful for a generation and two and three and four?
Exactly. You can't hurry things in winemaking, especially if you are thinking about like winemaking as an art or trying to create something valuable. But because there are some strategies or some areas where winemaking is a bit faster than normal. But yeah, this is the way.
Thanks for watching this video. You can watch the full podcast episode by clicking here, or watch another interesting video by clicking here. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section, and see you in the next one.